So we are back now with our breaking news here on CNN. Politico has obtained what it calls a draft of a majority opinion written by Justice Samuel Alito that would strike down Roe v. Wade. Senator Amy Klobuchar of Minnesota joins me now. Senator, good evening to you. Thank you so much for joining us. First of all, what is your reaction to this massive news?
It's unbelievable. And I will say none of us know what the final opinion will be. Things change. And again, this is just breaking news. But I will say that I predicted this in my questions of Amy Coney Barrett way back then, when she would not commit that Roe v. Wade was super precedent, to the predictions after the court arguments, that in fact, this court has been stacked and they are doing something where they are completely breaking with precedent if all of this news that we're hearing is correct. And I want to talk about the result, Don, because if this opinion is issued, it will be against the wishes of 80% of Americans who believe that women should have the right to make the their own healthcare system. It would trigger the laws in over 20 states mm-hmm. that have already said that they will outlaw abortion in their states. It will create a patchwork of laws across the country. And my prediction, Don, is that it will drive women to the polls, and men, anyone, that 80% of the public who believes that healthcare decisions should be made by a woman and her doctor and not by Ted Cruz. Yeah. This is going to have major impact,
Senator,
if all of this down as it looks.
I want to talk about the impact, but let's your earlier point, and then we'll get back to the impact because it is huge. But you mentioned your questioning of Amy Coney Barrett and others. So this is, I want to play that. This is what Trump Supreme Court nominees were asked about abortion, and this is how they answered. Watch this.
Is Roe a super precedent?
How would you define super precedent? And I'm answering a lot of questions about Roe, which I think indicates that Roe doesn't fall in that category. And scholars across the spectrum say that doesn't mean that Roe should be overruled. But descriptively, it does mean that it's not a case that everyone has accepted and doesn't call for its overruling.
As a judge, it is an important precedent of the Supreme Court. By it, I mean Roe v. Wade and Planned Parenthood versus Casey. Been reaffirmed many times. Casey is precedent on precedent, which itself is an important factor.
Senator, as the book explains, the Supreme Court of the United States has held in Roe versus Wade that a fetus is not a person for purposes of the 14th Amendment. And the book explains that.
Do you accept that?
That's the law of the land. I accept the law of the land, Senator, yes.
Wow.
So, yeah, what do you think? Yeah. What do you think of the responses? What do you think were they telling the truth in that moment?
Well, when they're saying it's the law of the land, and they arguably use this to convince certain senators to vote for them, I think that is a major problem. They said it was the law of the land. They are talking about the fact that it's been affirmed time and time again. And that's why I think a lot of people are shocked. I will tell you that I'm not shocked, because you could see this in the way the questioning went and the willingness, as you know, Don, in the Texas case, a different case, to actually in a shadow docket, no briefings, no public hearings, where they actually allowed a abortion ban to go forward that also include a bounty hunter provision, which allowed citizens to go after each other. It is an unbelievable shift in court decisions. And so I am, of course, as a member of the U.S. Senate, who someone believes that Roe v. Wade should be codified into law so we don't have a patchwork of state laws and we protect women from back alley abortions and bus rides across the country mm-hmm. just mm-hmm. to make their own personal health care decisions.
Or across borders.
I'm someone that I believe the Senate needs to act and act now.
Yeah, or across borders. But let me just read this and I want to get your response to it, because you talked about the ramifications of this and the fallout. And this is what a source is telling CNN that Roberts does not want to completely overturn Roe v. Wade, meaning apparently it would be a dissenting, he would be dissenting from Alito's draft opinion, likely with the court's three liberals, sources tell CNN. Roberts is willing, however, to uphold the Mississippi law that would ban abortion at 15 weeks after conception, CNN has learned. Under current law, government cannot interfere with a woman's choice to terminate a pregnancy before about 23 weeks when a fetus could live outside the womb. And I wanted to read that because I want to get this exactly right. So what do you make of Roberts not wanting to completely overturn Roe v. Wade?
Well, I think, first of all, I don't know where all this is coming from. And I do think leaks from the court are disturbing. But beyond that, I think that Justice Roberts has signaled, not just in the case before us with Mississippi, but in other cases, time and time again, a recent environmental case where he publicly came out against using the shadow docket, his upholding of the Affordable Care Act, the refusal to strike it down when looking at the law. He has clearly shown a sense of independence. I don't know what he's going to do in this case, but I think what your viewers have to understand is if, in fact, these five ultra-conservative justices do something like we've seen in this leak or that Politico is reporting, whatever Justice Roberts does, well, important to know where he's headed, is not relevant because that's a 5-4 decision. If, in fact, they all go against what many of them had said in the past, like the law of the land and that it's been reaffirmed many times, so it's precedent, and overturn this decades and decades long precedent.
Yeah. Senator Amy Klobuchar, thank you so much. I appreciate you jumping in here to speak to us about this. And we heard you. We heard you on the long-term ramifications and your question.
It is huge, and you have Republicans wanting to put a 6-week ban in already, as you know.
Yeah.
That's what we're dealing with here.